been building up to this, so. I was driving to work this morning and Leslie Gore was on the radio. Some of you are old enough to remember Leslie Gore. And she was saying, it's my party and I'll cry if I want to. So I hope I get through this without crying, but if I want to, I will cry. First of all, as others have said, a big shout out to the planning committee. You guys are amazing. Other duties as a sign. We're all very busy people with your actual job, so I'm humble and grateful for all the time you spent, from the table decorations to the special effects to everything in between. I'm not so sure about this legacy thing, but one thing I am very sure about, I would not have been able to accomplish the things that I've done without the people and experiences that have been part of my life along the way. As some of you know, I drove my 64 Chevy to Tallahassee, Florida in the summer of 76. I made a decision to seek the career path in student services, specifically the career services field, beginning at Florida State University. I am most grateful for the education I received from Florida State University's higher ed and counseling programs. My FSU education has been the key to the success that I've achieved. I've had the incredible honor and privilege to work in the career services field for more than 40 years. I must first thank my parents, Emily and Lester Lenz, hardworking blue-collar people in Richmond, Virginia, who never went to college, but who fiercely supported me in the pursuit of my dreams and higher education. As you've heard some today, they instilled in me a work ethic, show up on time, in my dad's case, early, and get the job done. I never heard them say, that's not my job. And that's influenced my work habits over the years. I also honor my sister Pam today. Her work as a special education teacher. There's a special place in heaven for teachers in general, but particularly special ed teachers who work to help these kids feel a sense of accomplishment and goals for their future. While she was often frustrated with the bureaucracy of the school system, she never lost her focus on trying to make a difference in the lives of these students. And there's some lessons in there for us as well. I'm grateful to have my nephews, Eric and David here, along with Eric's wife, Beth, and my amazing great nephew, many of you've already met, James. I use many stories in my work. David and Beth provide me with the alternative ways of working narratives. David has launched and successfully managed a lawn care and landscaping business for many years. Beth is a talented graphic designer who works from home and models how you balance work and family. Then there's Eric. I probably owe him royalties for telling his story so many times, how you take the Holland codes and EIS and perfectly implement them in the job, to have a successful career, in his case, in the field of medical sales. My cousin Bert and his wife, April, are here. Bert's mom, Alice Combs, was an important early role model for me, first woman in my family to go to graduate school. Also, let's acknowledge my kids by marriage, Bevan and Russell. While I actually care deeply about the environment, they actually do the work. Bevan here in Tallahassee in the Department of Environment Protection, and Russell and his wife, Carrie, who sent this beautiful lei all the way from Hawaii, which Bevan was the caretaker of for several days. They work in state and federal agencies making a difference in our environment, all while dealing with the government red tape that often makes doing this work very challenging, especially in these days and times. I admire and appreciate their efforts in this field. I have to give a shout out, as you've already heard, to my champagne girlfriends who are in the room today. They've been here for me to share my joys, my frustrations and sorrows. We all need those kind of friends on our life journey. I've been blessed to work with amazing colleagues, supervisors, department chairs, and graduate students at Florida State, without whom I would not be standing here. I also want to give a special shout out to those of you who work behind the scenes with policies, budgets, AORs, facets, administrivia, technology, etc. to make the rest of us look good. Martha, Lisa, Kelly, Tex, and Brian, who couldn't be here today. All the career center directors going back to Bob Shoemaker and Bob O'Neill, Jeff Garris, and finally Myrna Hoover have given me a place where I could thrive and use my God-given talents and skills, as well as occasionally allow me to rant about one thing or another behind closed doors. There was never a moment when I didn't feel supported in my professional development, and that's directly connected to their leadership and colleagueship. I also want to say thanks to the person I call our big boss, Dr. Mary Coburn. While my interactions with her were less frequent, I always felt heard and valued by Dr. Coburn over the course of my time at FSU. I also want to acknowledge Dr. Betsy Becker, my academic boss, who embraced this joint academic and student affairs position that I held and recognized the value that this collaboration brings to both sides of the institution. Prior to assuming my faculty role, I had the privilege of working with great teams over the years, 17 of them, in the career advising and counseling area. I love the opportunity to not only help students and other clients in that role, but mentor graduate students who become the next generation of person and professionals who are all over the country today doing that work. When people have asked me over the years what I love about my job, that is always one of the things I mention. To the original Tech Center crew, Jim Sampson and Gary Peterson, and one more, who I'll talk about in a minute, they embody how to put egos aside and be successful as a team. It sometimes takes longer to get things done, but the end result is worth it. The accomplishments on my vita are directly related to the support and guidance they have provided me over the years. They served as role models for me in mentoring master's and doctoral students and collaborating with colleagues, including the current team who will lead our Tech Center crew, Drs. Deb Osborne and Casey Cody. Finally, certainly not last and not least, but I say thank you to my partner in love, labor, and leisure, Bob Reardon, who challenges me, inspires me, and who has enabled me to do my best work over these many years. It's a real gift to share these life roles together and share a passion for the work that we've both been part of. It's been a fantastic ride so far. I look forward to many new adventures and using my office in this next life phase. Thank you all again for being here. Many of you who traveled from far and wide and making this a very special day. And now let's get back to the party and the cake. Yes.